Uganda starts first oil drilling, eyes output in 2025. Uganda Cooperative Alliance, once defunct cooperative bank revived. African economies set for faster recovery, according to African Development Bank. Kenya's diaspora remittances rise to $4.027 billion. And cost of living to hit African nations harder. Now, those are some of the trending stories in the world of business, locally, regionally, and internationally. Whatever it is, the good news is the oil is finally coming through 2025, not too far away. Well, with the drilling finally launched by the president on Tuesday this week, the hope is that everything keeps in place and whatever we have been hoping for stays intact. My name is Simon. Thank you so much for joining us on The Business Show this week. From wherever you're watching, we are glad you could make time. Here's what's coming up on the show tonight.
Our way of advocating for the environment through doing or making recyclable products or upcycled products, or what we call sustainable products that are eco-friendly, because many people do advocate for the environment, telling you the do's and the don'ts of the environment, conservation and all that. So me as a creative designer, I decided to make sure that I use materials that are friendly to the environment, but they are sustainable, that you can be able to use them.
Once again, welcome to the show. Now, in 1960s, when it was created, the Cooperative Bank offered what looked like a leeway for farmers to operate in groups, but also if there was any need of financing, they could get this because the money was saved in their, you'd call them SACCOs or cooperatives then, and then moved into the cooperative banks. Now, when this bank was put off, many years later, farmers have for long struggled to access financing. Now, government is being challenged to expedite plans to revive the defunct cooperative bank, which has been described as a possible game changer to financial needs of farmers. With about 45,000 registered cooperatives and 14 million cooperators, Ivan Asimwe, the General Secretary, says it's just a matter of time, and the back and forth by government should be addressed to offer farmers a platform through which they can get financing for the agriculture sector, which not only employs over 70%, but could be the fastest thing to change this economy. That and more in our views from the top this week.
Ivan Asimwe, the General Secretary of Uganda Cooperative Alliance, and I'm glad to have the media people here to discuss the issue of the cooperative bank. Uganda Cooperative Alliance is the apex body for all registered cooperative societies in Uganda, and it was established in 1961 by the cooperative movement. It was established before the bank, because we all know that cooperatives in this country started in 1913. And then in 1961, because the cooperative movement was very strong, they wanted a spokesperson. They wanted a representation, both at the national and international level. And those unions formed the Uganda Cooperative Alliance as their apex body. And since then to date, 61 years down the road, UCA is the apex body. If you have to look at the Ugandan context, the cooperative bank should ideally be helping farmers. Because without a cooperative bank, without a farmer's bank, it is so hard for the farmers to access affordable and appropriate financing. It is not easy. And this is what they have been asking for. We appreciate the government. Government has created ACF, the Agricultural Credit Facility. But this money is in the commercial banks. And the question is, who is accessing this money? If the cooperators are not accessing this money, if the smallholder farmers are not accessing this money, who is accessing it? That's why the cooperators, since 1999 to date, they have been pushing for a bank. We need a bank. We need our bank. We need our bank. Because they know what the bank used to do. Ideally, this cooperative bank was the one supporting the farmers with crop finance. You know, the cooperative movement was built in such a way that everything was moving on well. And they, and you know, these are guys, they didn't have PhDs, not even masters, but they had built a robust system whereby you have the cooperative unions. Maybe they are into coffee, they are into tea, they are into cotton, produce and others. Then there was also a structure of the marketing boards. The coffee marketing board, the lint marketing board, the produce marketing board. They have a training wing, which is a cooperative college. They have a transport wing, which is Uganda Cooperative Transport Union. They have insurance, which was also there. So from primary society, from a farmer, they are able to access the market. And they are able to access financing through the cooperative bank. Because now the cooperative bank would come in to bridge that gap of financing. So the ecosystem was working. So up to now, cooperators want to see such an ecosystem working. How does it work? So how do we support farmers? This is the need for a bank. Now, of recent, we have also seen as Uganda Cooperative Alliance, a pressure group agitating for the establishment of the bank. These are Ugandans, these are students, and they are concerned Ugandans. For us as UCA, we cannot downplay whatever they are doing. We can only advise, because we do the advisory role. We can guide them on how to do better. But they have a cause, because these are sons and daughters of farmers, and they see how their parents are struggling to access financing. So I think they are really pushing because they see there is a gap. It is not the role of the government to start a cooperative bank. It is the role of the cooperators to start a bank. What the government can do is to create an enabling environment for us to start. Secondly, is maybe to look at this issue, the issues which we raised as cooperators, especially the two pertinent issues. One, regarding the company that was closed. If they find that it was an illegal closure, then the government should take it up to compensate the cooperators. If it was legal, then they can also advise us. Because ideally, we need to work together with the government to make sure that we have a bank up and running. But it is the responsibility and the role of the cooperators to start the bank. We appreciate what the government is doing. We appreciate everybody, whoever, whichever pressure groups. But let us sit on the table with the government, with all stakeholders, and see how to revive the cooperative bank. But the shareholding is the cooperators. Thank you. A cooperative bank is based on cooperative principles. Much as it is doing business, but is based on cooperative principles. It's a cooperative. And you know, a cooperative is member owned. You own it, you use it, you control it, and you benefit from it. Those are four pillars. So why would farmers or cooperators want to have their bank? Of course, you also want to have your institution, which you control, which you use, which you own, and where you benefit. Yes, commercial banks are there, but the question is, do we own it? Is it our bank? When it generates revenue, who takes this revenue? Is it the cooperators or it is the investors? So that is ideally, that's why they want their bank. And it is not only Uganda. Most of these developed countries have cooperative banks. Go to our neighbors here in Kenya. The second largest almost is the Cooperative Bank of Kenya. You go to Tanzania, you go to South Africa, you go to Ethiopia, they have cooperative banks. Why? Because this is a bank. You know, the duty with a cooperative bank is that the shareholders are the cooperators. Now, once you are the shareholder, you are the user, You are the depositor, you are the borrower, then you have a stake, you have a say. During your annual general meeting, you can agree to fix interest at whichever rate you want as cooperators, which is impossible in the commercial banks because the rate the other side is fixed by the investors because they have their own interests. So that is why cooperators, the 14 million people, say, no, we need our bank because it will listen to our concerns. We have a stake, we can deliberate on the issues, we can make decisions regarding our investment. Regarding the conduciveness of establishing the bank, yes, when you look at our country, especially in areas of stability, political, economic stability, yes, the environment is there. But to start a bank or any investment, from the financing point of view, you need to carry out a study. You need to understand the dynamics. You need to understand the market. You need to understand the competition. You need to understand the shareholding. You need to understand the legal framework, the policy framework. You need to understand the clientele. You need to understand all those dynamics so that you are able to look for mitigants going forward. So that's why it is paramount that you need all this. But yes, regarding the conducive environment, it is there. Because this is a liberal economy, nobody can stop you from investing in something that is legal. But you have to move. You have to be extremely careful so that you start something and you don't look back. So as you see, we are taking lead. We are working very closely with the ministry to make sure that we have our bank up and running. And I'm very sure, because government is very positive and working together with us, and I really want to ask government, if possible, the government can support us, either financially or technically, or in any way, even spiritually, support the cooperators to establish a bank. Because once you have an indigenous bank owned by Ugandans, 14 million Ugandans, then you are sure that you are chasing out poverty. This money that is cut in different areas, the parish development model, there are a lot of trillions. If this money can be channeled through the cooperative bank, that's a very big portfolio. Look at the Myoga. If this money came in the same pot, look at the Youth Livelihood Fund, look at the Women Entrepreneurship Fund, look at all this money scattered. If this money can be brought together in one pot, and they say to support these farmers, because you have seen the president and the government, they are supporting farmers, they are supporting different skills, but the money is scattered. So if we can have this bank, and then we bring this money, consolidate it in one pot, this country can be transformed. And we shall no longer talk of the poor people, we shall talk of the first class economy. And subsequently, the government will generate more revenue. You know, you cannot collect more taxes when the tax base is low. And the tax base is low because the economy is low. So what you need, if you want to increase your tax base, you work on the economy, you work backwards. You support production, support value addition, support marketing, and you can only do this using the cooperative model, like it has done in other areas. You go to Brazil, you go to South Korea, you go to France, you go to Germany, you go to Netherlands, you go to Kenya here. My God, the economies are moving very fast because of cooperation. People are working together. You eliminate exploitation and you increase the synergies and you make sure that exploitation is done away with.
I mean, no doubt. Come to think of it, so the commercial banks offer rates that you cannot just compete with. The money is available, but the rates are not favorable for farmers. And of course, it's no doubt that agriculture is looked at as a very risky venture. So before a manager is going to put out money from a commercial bank, the question is, how safe is our money? And can they pay it within the agreed time? Of course, we know that there are efforts by government to try support different farmers through grants that have been issued out through different departments. But the cooperative alliance says this is not paying off, and that is the reason they are pushing for the revival of the cooperative bank. For now, we can only hope that the back and forth, like Asimwe says, can be handled and the farmers can have their bank back. You're watching The Business Show with me, Simon. Time now for a quick break. Don't go so far away. In the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. I'll see you shortly.